Hello everyone, my name is PythonGB and welcome back to the 31st episode of my Terraria Mage playthrough. Realistically, we don't have that many episodes left of this series, my friends, but for the most part, what we need to do is pretty much just farm things out and of course do the Force Moon, which will be something we're doing in today's episode. But before we do that, we have ourselves 5 Lizard Power Cells, and I also managed to farm myself a Life Root on the way down here, so let's use that thing. And hopefully what we're going to get from this is a heat ray. We would really, really like this because it'll be very useful against the early stages of the hard mode event. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be time-lapsing all of these battles because you've seen their battles way too many times now, I imagine. So without further ado, let's put down some clouds and let's get on with this thing. Ah, yeah. Alright, that's the first one down. It is an Eye of the Golem. Alright, we're gonna keep going. Alright, that's him down again. What is it this time? Yes! Second time going! Oh, that's fantastic! We have it, ladies and gentlemen, the heat ray is in our possession, sorry. There are now 4 weapons left on our priority weapons list to get. Yeah, that's really, really cool. And of course, we've got lizard power cells left to use. And we're going to pick up the lizard altar because, of course, you know, I'm saving up a little something, something for the finale, right? Yeah, it's going to be awesome, my friends. I'm really, really happy we got that pretty early as well. So, yeah, that's pretty awesome. I'll tell you what we're going to do is we are going to reforge this thing. It's only a default heat ray at the moment. I imagine with the right reforge, this might go into 3 digits in terms of damage. So I've got 85. Let's have a look. Keen, deadly, not bad. Look at that. Uses 6 mana, 95 damage. Not bad, not bad. Keen again, nimble, strong, quick, masterful. 98 damage. Uses 5 mana. Yes, okay, that's a very, very good reforge there. Yes, mystic and mythical are probably better, but this one is very, very good. You know, just within itself, it really is. So, yeah, I don't think we're going to need to do too much more in the way of reforging for that, because obviously I want to save up my money to reforge the other things that we're probably going to wind up getting in the series a little later down the line. So, the Frost Moon, ladies and gentlemen, is probably going to be the next thing we're going to try and do or survive against, more to the point. Yeah, the only thing is, it is currently nighttime already, and I have no idea where the moon is. Let me just, should we turn off the background really quick? Moon? There is no sign of the moon. Okay, so the moon has disappeared. He has got so scared of being around it. Oh, no, there it is. What the? How come I couldn't see that before? Was there, like, something in the way, like a cloud or something? Huh. Must have been. Right, okay, so, yeah, potions again a bit ridiculous. So let's put this in our, like, overflow chest. I've set up some overflow chests just at the side here. As you can see, we've got some building materials in here. And, yeah, all is looking good. So we have until the next night time to do something. I imagine Duke Fish Run will be the thing we'll do. God damn it, I really didn't want to have to do Duke Fish Run too many more times. I'll be honest with you guys. Oh, god damn it. Okay, we're going to go on a bit of a truffle worm hunt. I believe we have ourselves about 15 to 16 minutes to do this thing, so I need to keep a close eye on my recording time. So, yeah, I'm going to try and farm out some truffle worms and try to farm out some Duke Fish Runs in an attempt to get the bubble gun before we try the Frost Moon, ladies and gentlemen. So, yeah, let me get on with this thing, and I'll meet you guys, hopefully, if and when we get something good going. Ooh, this is going to be a bit of a difficult one. Here we go. Oh my god, I got him! Oh! That's some pro moves right there! God damn! Alright, let's keep going. Alrighty guys, unfortunately it is already the next night. I kind of missed the mark, which kind of sucks, and we've only managed to get 2 truffle worms from all of that session of farming, unfortunately, but it does mean we have 2 more chances of trying to get the bubble gun, so hopefully we can get this thing going. I do have a crystal ball installed here now, which is pretty awesome, and I guess without further ado, it is once again time to time-lapse these fights and see what we get from these things. Alright guys, I'll meet you guys back in just a second. go, there's the first jukefish one down! Oh, there's a bunch of sharks attacking me. Oh, good lord. There's a star as well. Another razor blade typhoon. Interesting. I've got to tell you guys, this razor blade typhoon is absolutely insane against the jukefish one boss. He really is. It really is. Look at it. 114 damage. It homes in on the enemy. And apparently, according to you guys, can shoot out up to 8 projectiles at the same time. So, you know, it's kind of cool, but we don't really need another one, do we? We need the bubble gun. So we're going to continue on with this. And yeah, hopefully we'll get it. Alright, there we go. That's the second jukefish one taken down. What do we got this time? It is indeed the bubble gun! Oh my god! This is brilliant! Oh, it's a bad one, but we can reforge it to get a good one. Oh my god! So that is now two weapons we managed to get in today's episode. That is amazing! Okay, so let's go ahead and quick stack what we've got. And once again, we're going to do a bit of reforging here. And we're going to see what kind of things we can get. Alright, nub. Oh, you good sir. You! Hello. Alright, what do you got? Shoddy. Adept. Uses less mana, but no extra damage. Strong. Superior. Not too bad. 127 damage. Oh, that's such a high amount. Superior again. I think we're playing with fire here. Hurtful. Keen. Annoying. Damaged. Deranged. Demonic. That's 132 now. And it's got more crit chance. I should probably keep it. We don't have a great deal of money left, do we now? We've got like 55 gold. Man. That's a funny thing with late game. You can spend so much money just in a few seconds. It's ridiculous. It really is. Right, okay. So let's go ahead and chuck some stuff in here. And I guess what we need to do next is basically wait for the next moon to come by, I guess, because that's all we really have to do. I mean, we've got nothing else from any of the other bosses we really want to try and get. We've got the shadow beam stuff, which I don't think is going to be entirely useful because most of our areas are flat, so I don't think reflecting off surfaces is going to be too useful. Anything to do in the meantime? I honestly can't think of anything at this point. In which case, like I said, I'll just wait until the next night comes and hopefully we'll take down the Frost Moon, or at least try to survive against them. Yeah, that's going to be pretty interesting, isn't it? Oh, man. All right, guys, I'm going to get on with it and I'll meet you guys on the next night. Alrighty, guys, I actually decided to do a little bit of farming in the underground hallowed ice biome because I believe I should be able to get the hallowed key mold from here if I'm very, very lucky. I have around 10 minutes of farming that I could do before I go back to the surface and get the nighttime, you know, frost moon on the way. So I really, really need to keep an eye on my blooming, you know, the amount of time I've been recording. So, yeah. But whatever the case, I'm going to try and farm out the hallowed key mold. If we don't manage to get it, then no worries. Again, we'll try it maybe in a future episode or off camera or something. But yeah, I'm going to get on with it and I'll meet you guys back, hopefully once we're ready, to take down the Frost Moon. What the hell? A Rod of Discord? What the hell did you get that from? Well, not even I know where I got that from. Okay, teleports you to the position of the mouse? What? What? The heck? Wait, what is it? What is it? It uses up your health, apparently. Oh, using the Rod of Discord will take life. Ah, right. Okay. Well, that's pretty interesting. So instead of using mana, it uses up your health. Interesting. But anyways, whatever the case, we still have a couple minutes before we have to go back for the Frost Moon. So I'm going to carry on with the farming. That was a pretty interesting find, actually. I've never, ever had the Rod of Discord before. So, yeah, let me get on with this, and I'll be back momentarily. Alrighty, guys, this will be the final dip down before going back. What have we got? That looks like a frost brand. Pretty interesting. Must have been a mimic down here. Not too bad. We've got a few other things from this as well. We've got, like, more more of these things, you know, flower frosts and whatnots. Again, from the frost chest mimics is where you get them from. Right, okay, so yes, I was correct. It is sunset right now, so we do have a little bit of time before we do this thing. We need to do a massive selling session, don't we, of all the weapons we don't really need. Obviously, the really high-end ones, like, you know, Flare on and Tsunami, I probably won't sell. But I'll probably put them in a different chest for the map download or something like that. I don't know. But, yeah, whatever the case, we are pretty much good to go, which I am very, very happy with. We have ourselves another banner to put down somewhere. Look at all the, look at the amount of banners we've got in these houses now. This is craziness. Not only that, but we now have a simply ridiculous amount of souls now. We have, a lot of souls of light and a mighty amount of souls of night. It's ridiculous. Right, okay. Leaf blower, that's pretty much, you know, derelict now. I don't think I'm going to be using that too much. I think this will be the order I use them in. So, got the heat ray, which is going to go for the early round, you know, just to sort of shoot through the rounds really quickly. And then later on, when we need to use the projectile-based mana weapons, this is what we'll use. So, yeah, we are pretty much just waiting at this point. I should probably buy some more mana potions, you know, just as a just-in-case kind of thing, I guess. So, let's go down. I'm going to buy some from Ye Olde Wizard. Maylor, hello. Alright, so that's 60, so we now have well over 100 at this point, which is very cool indeed. Right, okay guys, we're going to skip ahead until it becomes nighttime, and we are going to get on with this frost moon, my friends. Alright guys, the frost moon is among us! Let's do this thing! Do-do-do-do, this is how you do it. So yeah, this is what we're doing for the first round, so we're basically just going to use this thing, because it absolutely murks everybody. Wave 2 is already underway, which is very, very awesome. Wave 3 is now underway. Very awesome indeed. Alright, let's keep it going though. Alright, so I imagine... Oh, what's going on up here? I think I can hear a dude. Hello. I think... Was there like a... Was there a mimic somewhere? I feel like I heard a mimic. I don't know. Unless I'm like... Oh god, okay. We've already got the guys. Okay, this is going to get interesting. Alright, let's put a couple of these down just for a little wee bit more damage. And let's try using this thing. See how it does. Alright. Do-do-do-do-do. Might be a good idea to go over here to try and take down the tree dude. Look at that. 9,000, 8,000, 7,000, 6, 5. Yeah, this thing absolutely murks them. Oh my lord, this is fantastic. This razor blade typhoon, guys. It's just ridiculous. Alright, should we see how much damage this thing does? Whoa! Nice. Okay, the bubble gun does a very nice amount of damage as well. But which one to use? That is the question. I think I was right in, oh my god, look at that. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. He's dead. My god, that is quick. The bubble gun's ridiculous. Oh my god. The only thing is, you have to be fairly close to them. Which, kind of isn't good. Because, you know, you kind of want to get through these things and avoid their attacks, right? Because this thing has a very, very bad range on it. As you can quite clearly see, the bubbles dissipate after a very short distance. We are well out of range at the moment. We should probably get back, shouldn't we? Right. Okay. Do-do-do-do-do. Hello. How are you doing, sir? Hopefully you're all good. Right, now where is everybody? Hello, Mr. Copter. Those copters are a massive pain in the buttookie. Right, here we go. Oh, God. I don't know about not having the Ankh Charm equipped. Oh, yeah, we're getting knocked about something fierce right now. Oh, my God. We may need to put the regenerative set on, or we may need to change an accessory. I have no idea, but I don't think I like being knocked about too much. It's not good. It's not good. Hey, buddy. How you doing? I don't want to get near you because you might do a lot of damage. Oh. Huh? Yeah, he does a lot of damage, as I would have expected. Okay. I'm just going to use this thing just because we can stay at range, I guess. I really need some time. I need some time to bloomin' try and figure out my next sort of strategy of attack, I guess, or something like that. I don't know. All right, got a bunch of present mimics, which of course give us a bunch of hearts, which is awesome source. I really, really want this thing though. I may have to swap out the celestial stone. This may be a bad idea. I don't know, but I really, really dislike being knocked about, especially with all of them using their guns and whatnots. You know what I mean? It's just going to be a massive pain in the ass. Yeah. I think that might have been a good idea. I don't know. Have I got anything else I could have potentially replaced instead? I don't think so. Interesting. I don't know why I'm trying to use so many weapons. I should probably just stick to one and just try and go for it, I guess. Alright, okay. Hearts are all good right now. We're still on our offensive set of armor, which I guess is kind of cool. Oh, there's another sand tank. Hello! Hey, hey, hey! Y'all are going to get murked! Oh, so are you. Okay, my god. Come on, bubble gun. Do your job, buddy. 5, 4, 3, 2, I'm almost dead. Oh boy. Okay, regenerative set is going on. Ooh. Oh boy. Things are getting a bit hairy. Oh, maybe not. Full health has been achieved. Nice. Oh, I keep forgetting about the blooming flying freaking thing projectiles. It's so annoying. Wow, this thing doesn't do a great deal of damage against the copters, does it? I'm actually kind of surprised. Alright, I may have to resort to this thing. Let's go for it. Just absolutely murk them all. That's the name of the game right now. Alright. Come on! Blooming copter guys! Bunch of jerkbags! I really want the tree dudes to spawn. Oh, there he is. Bang on time. Awesome stuff. Okay, my little heart statue is doing its job very much, which is cool. Should probably chuck down a couple of these just while I'm trying to pwn them, I guess. Here we go. The damage is real against two bosses at the same time. Come on. Oh my god. I got a feeling they may have nerfed the regenerative thing a little bit, maybe? I don't know, man. I wasn't getting quite the high amount of regeneration as I thought I would be getting. I don't know, maybe that's just a balancing thing. I would assume so anyway. Right, okay. Both of these guys are very almost dead at this point. And, nope, present tense, they are dead. Okay, sweet. I'm not going to lie to you guys. I'm actually kind of nervous about the Ice Queen. I'm very, very nervous about the Ice Queen. Oh, please go away. You're such an annoying piece of butt. You really are. You're a piece of butt, apparently. That's what I just called you. Indeed. You know. There are many insults that are worse than that, good sir. Oh, boy. Come on. Hey, Krampus. Oh, look at you guys. Come on, Ann. Bunch of idiots. You think you can take me down? I'm the almighty Python. I have a bubble gun. I'm killing you with bubbles right now. How do you feel? How do you feel about that? Hopefully you're feeling pretty bad and or very embarrassed, because I would be very embarrassed as well if I was being killed by bubbles. Yeah. I'm sorry, man. It's just how it is. It's just how it is. Alright, there we go. That's that guy down. No sign of a razor pine just yet. That would be a very, very good weapon indeed to have. In all seriousness, that would be very good. Alright. Ah, damn copters, man. They're all over the place. Hello, Krampus. Krampus. What a funny name. Okay. Alright, another tree dude. Okay, cool, cool, cool. You wanna come down here into the clouds, maybe? Maybe? Come on, into the clouds, you butt. There we go. 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. So much death. It's ridiculous. Alright, he's dead. Still no sign of any drops. This is kind of disappointing, actually. Would have expected just a little something. Come on. Oh, have I got anything? Nah. Definitely got nothing so far. Oh my god, your gun does so much damage. It really does. Alright, 6k. I imagine after this, we might have the Ice Queen spawning. I don't know. Something like that. Okay. Alright, he's dead. Sweet. Ice Queen! Oh, there she is! Uh-oh. Not good. Not good. Not good. Alright, how are we going to do this? I think this might be the thing to use. Alright, Ice Queen. Yep. Okay, yeah. This is a very, very good thing to use. I'm pretty much just spamming it just so we can try and get the projectiles on her most of the time. So here we go, there we go. Do all the damage, there we go. It doesn't do a great deal of damage though. Damage per second is in. I don't know, man. This is a pretty slow method of killing her. But it guarantees that I'll hit her every time. Oh, Flockos. Careful. Alright, Ice Queen. The thing we get from the Ice Queen, of course, is the Blizzard Staff. If we can get that first time, I will literally... I don't know, man. I'll probably fall off my chair with excitement or something. Yeah. Well, except I probably won't, let's be honest. Alright, okay. I really need to try and focus her down. She's got 18k health still. Which is a lot, let's be honest. And she's doing a lot of damage. This isn't doing a great deal of damage. That's the only thing. This is the problem I've got right now. And more to the point, it keeps all the projectiles keep going down to all the other guys. Do you know what I mean? It's kind of annoying. Alright, so this is what we're going to try and do. We're going to get over here. There we go, do a bit of damage with that, perhaps. I could try using this thing, but I don't think it's going to work too well. Oh, yeah, she gets set on fire, though, which I guess is kind of cool. The moon is almost down at this point. I wanted to try and take down at least one Ice Queen. 10k? Come on, buddy. It's so difficult to predict where she comes from or goes. No, please go away, man. I just want to kill the Ice Queen. I don't want anybody else near me. Come on. Come on, be nice, be nice. How's it doing? How's she doing? How's she doing? 6k still. The moon is almost down. Come on. I want to kill her. I can't believe this is only the first Ice Queen we're killing. Oh my god. No, Wyvern, you're not helping matters, dude. Get out of here, you stupid idiot. Right, come on, come on, come on. 4k. Come on. Come on, get murked. I might die here, actually. Oh, pirates! Really? You're gonna give me pirates now? Okay, I'm pretty sure I didn't even kill the Ice Queen either. Oh, god damn it! Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was probably the most unproductive Frostmoon in the entire world. Absolute diddly squat. Oh, come on, RNGesus. Be nice to me, buddy. Come on. Oh.